All right, true believers. And it was a very interesting weekend this past weekend. We were going to go with one case, but this case overtook everything. This is a case of a stalker from Long Island. More specifically Gilgo Beach. And he was dubbed the Long Island serial killer. And he stalked sex workers. And allegedly, some might say, more than just sex workers he stalked. But he was a stalker slash serial killer. Alleged. We don't know 100% sure, but police investigators are 75% sure that this man, Rex Heuermann, is the Long Island serial killer. And that's what we're going to delve in today, you guys. Rex Heuermann. ...59-year-old guy. That's kind of old to become a serial killer, but I believe he's been doing this for a long time. So if you have any information on this Long Island suspect here, please contact these places. Don't contact me. I'm just an artist. I cannot do anything with the information. You need to seek authorities. Strap yourselves in, guys. In the next couple of seconds, we're going to go into the world of the Freedom to Draw Unsolved Mysteries with your host, me, John Krupa. And we're going to start drawing Mr. Heuermann and tell you about the story leading up to his arrest and them saying that he is the prime suspect in 4 homicides, and I'm going to draw them at the same time. So this article is from CNN. It was just reported a couple of hours ago. This is very recent news, guys. And we're listening to, in the background, it's the Korean Constitution today is, so I put on some traditional Korean music for us to listen to as I'm drawing Mr. Heuermann. The day has finally come, years in the making. Evidence leads investigators to Rex Heuermann. Yeah, they didn't just wake up one day and say, we're going to arrest this guy. They've been tailing him for years. Rex Heuermann left his office near the Empire State Building and strolled down a still bustling Fifth Avenue as the sun set on a hot Thursday evening in Manhattan. The 59-year-old architect, whose customers included Catholic charities, American Airlines, and other tenants at John F. Kennedy International Airport, is seen in a video obtained by the CNN affiliate WABC, walking calmly at the end of a workday. A bag was slung over his shoulder, his left hand in his pocket, when he's approached by several men in dark suits and ties. Yes, this kind of reminds me of BTK killer. He's probably been doing this for a long time. Just got caught. I wouldn't be surprised if he was doing this since the early 2000s, late 90s. It's hard to judge this man knowing that I know he is a suspect. But doesn't he just look like an evil individual? Tall and heavy set, Heuermann towered over the law enforcement officers who now surrounded him as passerby strolled leisurely along the avenue. He was taken into custody without incident in connection with a 13-year-old homicide investigation involving young female victims on the south shore of Long Island. Yes, the day has finally come when someone so depraved of the heart who would kill individuals, innocent individuals, in the prime of their lives, their young lives, is finally brought to justice, New York Governor Kathy Hochul said Friday. We are hoping that this will bring justice to this individual, but also peace to the families. That day finally came years after a best-selling nonfiction book, a Netflix drama, and a podcast about long-running murder mysteries that made national headlines and became known as the Gilgo Beach Killings. Here's a picture of him after he was arrested. Heuermann is charged with 3 counts of first-degree murder for the killings of Melissa Bartholomew in 2009, Megan Waterman, and Amber Costello the following year, according to the Suffolk County District Attorney. The alleged killer had been living a double life in a Long Island village, a short drive from where their remains were found, prosecutors said. Heuermann was told his attorney, he's not the killer, is also a prime suspect in the 2000 disappearance and death of a fourth woman, Maureen Brainerd Barnes, according to a bail application from Suffolk County prosecutors. He has yet to be charged in this case. And here is the Gilgo Beach Four that they're known as. These are the women that he's suspected in killing. They're all young, petite, and pretty. as we listen to the Korean instrumentals on this Korean Constitution Day. The victims who worked as escorts became known as the Gilgo Four. On Friday, Heuermann was ordered held without bail after pleading not guilty during a first court appearance. Heuermann was in tears following his arrest. "I did not do this," his court-appointed attorney Michael Brown said, his client told him. A crucial break in the case came in January when investigators took a swab from leftover pizza crust Heuermann discarded in the trash outside his Manhattan office, according to the bail application. And he was living a double life, they say. So what investigators say, this guy was a father of two, had a special needs son and a 20-some-year-old daughter. Kind of remnants of the BTK killer if this guy did do it. BTK was a father of three, I think. We got an episode on him. All you gotta do is look back. If you're a subscriber, you just look back on this show and look for the thumbnail. Most of the time, I put the thumbnails in the areas where they were doing the crimes, and his case would be Wichita, Kansas. Just need to look through the thumbnails for the location and you'll be able to find it easily. It's under Dennis Rader, which is his real name, BTK. This case is similar to this guy. The son of an aerospace engineer, Heuermann lived with his spouse and children in the homey village of Massapequa Park across the bay from where the remains were found on the southeastern edge of Nassau County. In a video interview posted online by Bonjour Reality last year, as police in Suffolk County formed a multi-agency task force to investigate the long dormant cases, Heuermann said he was born and raised on Long Island. He had been working as an architectural consultant in Manhattan since 1987. "I do troubleshooting, architectural troubleshooting and negotiations with the building department," Heuermann said. "When a job that should have been routine suddenly becomes not routine, I get the phone call," he added. And that's why I suspect this guy's been doing this. Maybe since the 80s. We don't know at this point. There's going to be more victims connected to this guy. I can pretty much guarantee it. So keep your ears open about this case, and we will be doing updates about this case, definitely. That's for sure. It's almost a foregone conclusion. Constitution Day, and we're listening to the Korean instrumental music. Investigators were piecing together a complex puzzle. It took investigators nearly 15 years to track down Heuermann. They first connected him to the killings last year while conducting a review evidence under a newly formed task force, which included the Suffolk County Police Department, the Suffolk County Sheriff's Office, the New York State Police, and the FBI. In March 2022, investigators found that a first-generation Chevrolet Avalanche, the same type of truck a witness believed to have been driven by Costello's killer, registered to Heuermann at the time of the murders, according to the bail application. Armed with more than 300 subpoenas and search warrants, investigators began to close in on Heuermann. Evidence revealed the killer had used burner phones to contact victims. Investigators found calls to the victims or originated from locations connected to Heuermann. So they have a lot of evidence on this guy. Like I said, it's not like they just woke up one morning and targeted him. The guy's in a lot of trouble. Investigators said they narrowed cell towers records from thousands of possible individuals down to hundreds and then down to a handful. They focused on residents who matched the physical description provided by a witness who had seen the killer. Task force members also learned Heuermann lived close to the Long Island call cell site and worked near New York City cell sites where other calls originated. A series of taunting calls in which a male caller admitted killing and sexually assaulting Barthelemy were made from her phone to her family members from the vicinity of Heuermann's Midtown Manhattan office during the summer of 2009, according to the bail application. Heuermann also used burner phones to contact sex workers or massage parlors, the bail application said, and he created false names for an email account used to search for sex workers, sadistic torture-related pornography, and child pornography, the bail application said. Guy's a pretty sick individual. They have a mountain of evidence for him, against him too, so he could say he didn't do it all he wants, but it's not looking good for this guy. One fictitious email account was used to send selfies to solicit and arrange for sexual activity. Another was used to search for podcasts and documentaries about the investigation, as well as images depicting the murdered victims and members of their immediate families, according to the bail application. Between March 2022 and June 2023, Heuermann used the same account to conduct more than 200 searches about serial killers and articles about the task force investigating the Gilgo Beach killings, the bail application said. A rag, a bone, and a hank of hair. A key break in the case came when investigators recovered Heuermann's DNA from pizza crust in a crumpled box he discarded in Manhattan trash can in January. The initial examination of Waterman's skeletal remains turned up a male hair from the bottom of the burlap the killer used to wrap her body, according to prosecutors. Analysis of DNA found on the victim and the pizza show the samples matched. Additionally, hair believed to be from Heuermann's wife was found on or near three of the murder victims, according to bail application. The DNA was collected from bottles inside a garbage can outside Heuermann's house. The hairs were found in 2010 and had degraded. DNA testing at the time yielded no results, but recent mitochondrial DNA testing allowed investigators to make the connection, according to Tierney. Heuermann's wife and children were out of state when the three women are believed to have been killed, Tierney said. Investigators said his wife's hair may have been transferred to the victim from his clothing. Authorities, fearing that Heuermann might be tipped off they were closing in, moved to arrest him Thursday night. We were playing before a party of one, Tierney told reporters. We knew the person responsible for these murders would be looking at us. I did follow this case, but never made any videos of it. This is the first one I made of this. But I am familiar with this case. This case started with the search of a missing woman in 2010, leading to the discovery of multiple sets of human remains at Yogo Beach. By the time the remains of the missing woman, Shannon Gilbert, were found, 1 year later, at least 10 sets of human remains had been recovered across two Long Island counties. Tierney said Saturday, "The work of the task force is not over. There are a lot of other victims, you know, in that area," he told reporters. "There are a lot of victims, families that want closure, so that's what you work towards." Authorities believe the death of Gilbert, whose disappearance sparked the discovery of the other victims, may have been accidental and not related to the other killings, but that Sarah Gilbert was said that she was on drugs and spooked by somebody. She escaped from somebody that scared the crap out of her, and I believe it was this guy that scared the crap out of her, and she was running from him, and then she ran into the marsh in the middle of the night at Gilgo Beach, and then she succumbed to the elements. So that's what I think happened. Guys, that does it for this case right now. There's going to be a lot more videos on this, I guarantee you. So for right now, we'll let the Korean instrumental music, because it's the Korean Constitution Day, let us play. Let that play us out, guys. Thanks for watching. Peace out, true believers.